Hello Aston MTB fans, today we've got a treat for you, something that's even good enough to make this grumpy moaning Brummy happy and smiley, almost. My custom built Aston Titanometron, I don't know what it's called, but it's an absolute beauty in my humble opinion. The best looking mountain bike I've ever seen and probably the best handling mountain bike in the world, in my humble opinion. So what the hell is it? This is my titanium custom built Edgery Velo from France. An absolute beauty. Those of you that have been following me for a while saw the steel bike I had last year, made by Nico. This is the updated version. The only problem we had with the old one was a bent derailleur hanger and bent derailleur. So we went for a pinion gearbox to sort out that issue. No more bent derailleurs. Just look at that, look how clean that is. Way nicer than having a stupid, big, dangly mech here, ready to smash into all the things. Check these bad boys out, build bike better. Even got a carrot on the braking finger. Dog's going crazy. I'm filming here, you're bloody noisy. So, my vision of the perfect mountain bike. 200mm travel front and rear. This bike is designed to do anything from World Cup downhill tracks to pedaling down the road. It can do it all. I don't know where I was now. So what is it? This bike is my vision of the perfect mountain bike, do-it-all machine that can do anything from World Cup downhill tracks, cross-country, enduro, whatever you want. It's designed to do everything. The previous steel bike was almost perfect for me. A couple of slight changes to the geometry on this one. Head angle's the same at 62 and the seat angle is the same at 80 degrees. I'm quite tall, so super steep 80 degree seat angle. You can climb this on anything, comfortable position, and the seat is still right bang in the center of the rails. So I've got a little bit of adjustment forwards and backwards. All the other bikes that I ride for years always end up with the seat slammed completely to the front. Even the last YT Capra test bike, the saddle slammed right to the front and it was better for climbing. I wanted it further forward. A little bit longer on the reach than the previous bike. This is 510 instead of 500. The previous bike felt a little bit short because the long chainstay makes the front end feel shorter. So a little bit longer on this one. It was almost perfect. We're nitpicking here. This bike's got a slightly shorter chainstay, 490mm static. I'm not sure what it is at sag. 10mm shorter than the previous bike. I couldn't pop a full manual on the previous bike because the chainstay was too long. But in my opinion, manuals are for the skate park or BMX track. My BMX is really good at manualing. This is a mountain bike. It wants to be balanced for off-road mountain biking. That said, I can still pop the front wheel enough, easily enough to get over any obstacles on the trail, like a manual 2 or 3 meters. I can't pop it into a full manual, but who cares? That's for the skate park. Also on this bike, we've gone slightly higher with the bottom bracket, plus 10mm BB drop or BB rise. I'm going to go into the geometry more in some future videos, but the future of BB heights, I believe, are going to get higher. Longer chain stay, higher BB. We'll see. I like to think I've been right about a lot of things over the last sort of 10 years in mountain biking. Shorter stems, shorter offsets, slacker head angles, longer reaches, all these things. This is going to be the next major shift in geometry, I believe. The frame's constructed by Egery Velo Moto in France. Quick turnaround on this. I think it took 6 weeks from when I ordered it to get it. Pretty similar frame. Slight differences are gone for the integrated seat clamp. I don't know why I didn't have that on the old one. There's no strengthening support between the seat stays, unlike the previous one. I tried the previous one with and without the two supports. There wasn't as much difference as I expected, so this one a little bit lighter tubing, that support's not there. Hopefully give us some more flex for grip. Along with that, we've got the DH Cyan wobbly bushings. Now the only problem I had with the previous bike was in 7 or 8 months. The only problem was a bent derailleur and a bent derailleur hanger, because derailleurs for mountain biking are still hanging off the back of the bike here, just getting pounded by mud and rocks and all sorts of crap on the trail. The derailleurs, the ultimate polished turd. Yeah, they're really good. Yeah, they've got a big range. Yeah, you can get electric. Yeah, they're pretty lightweight now, but it's just a load of crap, really. You need a gearbox. It's an off-road mountain bike. Well, the derailleur needs to be put out of the way, out of harm's way. Also, dropping the derailleur takes about 800 grams off the back of this bike. So 800 grams off your unsprung weight. That means the rear wheel can just move up and down really easily. Get out of the way of the bumps. And yeah, every time the suspension moves, it's not pushing and pulling that 800 grams. Speak to any suspension expert in any area of moving vehicles with suspension. Unsprung to sprung weight ratio, incredibly important. I've taken the best part of a kilo off the back of the bike. Only reason was people kept saying my old bike was too heavy and it was upsetting me. So I went for titanium. Not that I wanted titanium particularly, but this frame's about a kilo lighter than the previous one overall. I think the frame weighed in at 3.7 kilos, which is actually lighter than a medium Nikolai G1. So we're pretty light. Obviously we've added the pinion gearbox, which is heavier than a derailleur. So that's sort of added some of that weight back on. But overall we've got a lighter package, less weight on the rear, more weight in the center of the frame for stability, and yeah, 12 gears in there, completely sealed, always lubricated, always running smooth. No mud can get in there, no water can get in there. You can change gear at any time. Bang first, bang 12. You can change gear while you're coasting, jumping, pedaling. More about the pinion in some future videos. The rest of the build, very similar to the old bike, because I wanted some of the parts to change over. Firstly, so I didn't have to buy loads more expensive mountain bike parts. Secondly, the parts were fantastic. Brand X Ascend dropper, 200mm, I think 140 quid from Chain Reaction. Had it on there for 6 months, no problems. SQ Lab saddle, best saddles you can get in my opinion. Nice high sitting area that supports your sit bones. DT Swiss wheel set, 25mm EX471 rims on Hope hubs. Again, full downhill spacing on the back of here, 157, 12mm spacing with a 7-speed downhill hub. This one I've got a gearbox. I could have gone a lot narrower, but as I just said, I want some of the parts to swap over for ease of changing things between bikes. That's one reason. Also, this Hope downhill 7-speed rear hub has almost perfectly symmetrical spoke spacing. Again, speak to any wheel building expert. The most important thing for a good wheel build is equal spoke symmetry and tension. Continental tires, not really a fan of these, too square in my opinion, even on the 25mm rim, on a 30mm rim, really square. Using those just to wear them out now, and I'll probably go back to a pair of front minions soon. Other things that stayed the same, the Hope brakes, a fresh set of Tech 4s on here, Tech 4 V4, absolutely amazing brakes. Just every time I ride one of my bikes with those brakes on, they just always feel perfect, always aligned properly, never dragging, the rotors don't warp, the power's incredible, the feel's incredible, the dogs are still barking. Yeah, absolutely beautiful brakes, braided hoses. What more can you say about those brakes? Fantastic. Slightly different handlebar setup, gone for the Stooge Moto Bar. This was a leftover from another bike last year. 17 degree back sweep and 5 degree up sweep and 800mm wide. So pretty similar to my preferred SQ Lab bar, just a little bit wider and a little bit taller. I'm not set on this bar yet. I think I'll be putting another SQ Lab bar back on soon. Grips, push on grips as always. I've got some different ones. On the left hand side, I've got a Renthal MX Ultra Tacky grip. And this is a dual compound with a diamond and a waffle underneath. And I have got another one to put on the pinion side, but that needs cutting for the shifter, the grip shifter. So I'll just use an old Renthal grip on there to choose where I want to get the shifter in the right place before I cut the nice grip. But yeah, it's gonna have Renthal push-ons both sides eventually. Stem, slightly different stem. This is a Rulesman RRT V1 downhill stem from 1973 or whenever we built it. Super high rise, I think it's 50 mil rise and 18 mil length. It's hard to get any sub 50 mil mountain bike stems now, or any stems with a good rise without having to put 1,000 stem spacers underneath like Greg Minar. This is like the initial build, so that stem, testing it out for the time being. We'll see how it goes, might keep it, might change it. Suspension wise, also from Rulesman, from the guy who built the stem. At the back, custom tuned Cane Creek Kitsuma on these D8 Cyan sort of floating spherical bushings. Ah, here's the other dog now. Luna, I'm trying to film. Not bothered. This shock's essentially standard. Slight upgrade on the high speed shim stack. I was getting quite close to the end of the high speed compression. So Dave sort of bumped up the shim stack to keep me more in the middle of the settings. And that gives me more space to go either way if I need to. And up front, the Rulesman Dorado Alloy RRT 37 LEA2, all the acronyms. The second Aston Edition fork. The first one I gave away in a competition and I really should have kept it. It's really upset me that I gave that away, but I needed to try and keep the business alive. This one is the second one, all silver, anodized silver. Custom Dorado drop crown from Rulesman. These Dorado forks are way too short with a standard drop crown. You can barely squeeze them onto any headset. Bad design, Manitou, you've really failed there. You need to get more drop crowns or just make the legs 2 centimeters longer so that it will fit on more bikes. Be aware, if you are gonna buy a Dorado and your head tube's more than 110, probably not gonna fit. This fork, unbelievably supple. Well, both ends of the bike, unbelievably supple. I'm injured at the moment, but I just did a little pedal up and down the road. Compress the fork, climbing up really steep grades, just with your hands flat on the bar, and it'll still go. Super sensitive. Oh my God, yeah, that's nice. Most forks won't move at all when you're climbing, when all your weight's on the back of the bike. This one, fantastic. Mega supple, and this has got the sort of finalized tune, because I had 2 of these forks last year on other bikes. Did loads of data testing with Rulesman, and we then sort of modified our tune to get me my perfect handling fork, and it's unbelievable. For the 2 runs that I did before I crashed, it was felt absolutely amazing. Same with the shock. We did a lot of testing last year with the data acquisition system, and we found that the more linear the bike was, the better bottom out resistance it has, which is completely contra to what people normally think. So this bike's essentially completely linear. I can actually flip the shock mount around in 4 different ways to adjust the progression. Can actually go slightly regressive also. Idler wheel mounted directly onto the pivot, not the perfect anti-squat number, and a lot of frame engineers are gonna say it could be better anti-squat. If you move the wheel down to get the chain in line with the center of the pivot, I tested both on the old one with an adjustable unit, and Nico from Eggery also tested it. Both found the same thing. It pedals better with the worse anti-squat. We think it's because there's no chain tension between the front chainring and the idler wheel creating the anti-squat. So it actually pedals better, freer, more smoother in the setup. Bottle cage, whoa, crazy. Got a bottle cage, because you can't go mountain biking without a bottle cage. Little tool bag, need to get my one-up tool and pump on there. Apart from that, that's it, absolutely. The 2 runs I did in it, best runs of my life. Super silent, super supple. Like, look at that. Single pivot, coil shock, spherical bearings. What more do you want? Just unbelievably supple. Same with the fork, just, oh my God. Yeah, that's nice. My chain rings come loose. So there we have it, my attempt at a quick introduction video to this bike. There's gonna be a lot more content about this in the future, about the geometry, the suspension, the gearbox, some of the parts on it, I've got some different parts to change and this build is going to evolve. Got some new suspension coming to try out and a few other really interesting goodies. Some hints I can give you are Novi parts, Avalanche and Boss. So some really interesting stuff coming. If you like this video and you like this bike, head to my website now. You can win your own custom built Eggery frame exactly to your spec. Unbelievable prize. It's for a steel frame painted exactly to your spec. You can work with Nico from Eggery and with me to dial in exactly what you want. If you want to get a copy of this or you want a completely different bike, whatever you want from Eggery. You can also win Rulesman products, €3,000 to spend. €3,000 will get you one of these forks, or it'll get you a Manitou Mezza and a Cane Creek Kitsuma set up perfectly to your bike. Or you can get an Intend Edge or Hero fork if you win that prize. You can also win some Aston MTB gloves like these guys, little carrots on the fingers for braking. You can win some of these amazing Hope Tech 4 brakes, brand new, any rotor size, any colour, shipped to you anywhere in the world. Absolutely fantastic prize. So there we go, quick introduction video. Hope you liked it. Go and buy some competition tickets and yeah, let me know in the comments if you've got any questions about this machine. And the next video, I'll start to answer some questions and give you some more information. Thanks very much for watching. See you soon.